YouTube, what's going on? Welcome back to another reaction video. We have a brand new band today, a band that we haven't covered on the channel before, a band that I've heard one song from before, to my knowledge. I don't know, maybe I've heard more, I just don't know them. But I know I've heard one song by this band, and it's an absolute slapper. And now we're introducing them to the channel, and I'm excited to do so. We have The Black Crowes, My Morning Song, a song that was suggested by Jeff, a dono request no less. And one that he definitely suggested like months back, and I filed that away in a mental note, and then unfortunately, to a boy such as myself, mental notes don't always hit the best as far as information retention goes. I'd be needing physical notes more often than not. So unfortunately, I kind of just forgot it existed. However, he brought it back. He was generous enough to drop a donor request, and I always mention in the donor request videos, obviously it's always optional, but there is a link in the description if you ever want to support the channel and get a song reacted to on the channel in an expedited fashion. We'll listen to My Morning Song today. I know Hard to Handle. That's what I was getting at earlier. I know Hard to Handle, and it's an absolute slapper, so I have positive expectations for My Morning Song. And as well to Jeff's taste, so I have high hopes. All right, it's hot, and I don't want to have to sit in front of this window for too long. So let's listen. Credits there, I guess you need to do. Getting like CCR vibes or Zeppelin vibes just early on. Yeah, I keep saying this, I don't know if it's just because it has been sunny recently, so songs feel like they're fitting that, but it's got quite like, I like listening to it in the sun. It's got like a summery, I have a playlist, it's like classic rock that you could listen to on a summer road trip. I can't remember what the playlist is called, I think it's called Summer Rocky Road Trip. And it's, as I said, it's CCR vibes, it's Led Zeppelin vibes, it's got that sort of similar vibe, even though I think that these guys kind of were most prominent in the 90s, and I'm talking about bands from like, oh, the release date isn't even on this one, 1992, so I'm talking about, it's got those kind of like 60s, 70s, like classic rock vibes, even though it was a song from the 90s, which I think is really cool. It's really cool actually to keep that sort of stuff going. You've got a very like full voice, like there's a lot going on in his voice, if that makes sense. Here we go. Oh, this is cool. So they have like a... hot effing fall. Oh, okay. I can't, are we switching a little bit? Tone slowing down a little bit. I was gonna comment on how there was like a mini solo and the vocals came back in, but like the guitar carried on and then the vocals went out and then it was like a solo carried on. So I thought that was interesting. It was a little different. Like the kind of a change of pace here, a change of tone. If your rhythm ever falls out of time, you can bring it to me and I will. Yes, I will make it for right. Wow, you know I'm real, I'm trying, baby. But if I try, ooh, will you let it? Wow, yeah, will you let your soul go? Let your mind go, let your heart go, let your soul go. Yeah, the guitar in the background has been really nuts this whole time. I've started listening to the lyrics a bit more. But he's going for it. And back up. I nearly said earlier, but I didn't really find a good time to pause. But I was gonna say when it kind of came down a little bit, I was like, I can feel this being one of the songs. Consider it started quite like you know, they kind of established the tone and the energy, and then they had that bit where it like broke down a little bit, and it got a little bit more. I don't know, it was kind of a bit more broken down, a bit more stripped back. I was like, in my head, I was like, it'd be really cool if they came back at the end of the song, if they came back to the energy of the first bit, and they came back with that chorus again, that'd probably hit pretty hard, that'd probably sound really cool. Surely enough, that's exactly what they did. What was really interesting there to me, and I don't know if this is just something that I never really noticed before, or this is, like, I don't know, but this is just what I noticed in that particular song. The way the solo kind of kept going, almost, or like, that was part... And I know that it sounds like it's not a solo if there's singing, but then I guess how pedantic do you want to be, or like how like specific is the term? Because, you know, there'll still be like drums and stuff going on through solos, but it's still a guitar solo, I guess. So I don't really know the specifics of how the term guitar solo works. I kind of just, you listen to one and you're like, oh, there's a solo. But that one was kind of a bit different because, as I said, it felt like a guitar solo started and then... the vocals came back in, so it was like, oh, it's just a little short one, but then what felt like was the guitar solo kept going in the background through the vocals, so I don't know if that's not a solo anymore because he was singing, but it felt like the solo carried on, and then the singing stopped and the solo was still going, so then it went back to a solo, and then eventually the singing came back, and it felt like kind of that sort of solo or whatever the guitarist was doing kind of from the point of the first solo starting, it kind of kept going throughout and kind of stayed as like this foundation. And it, but it was different. It wasn't like, oh, it was just a guitarist playing the guitar. It wasn't like rhythm. It wasn't like melody. It felt like a solo. And sometimes it happens. Sometimes the vocals will come back in as the solo's ending, but it felt like he just kept going. Which is interesting. I could easily see that being like kind of freestyling, or like maybe in the moment they just kind of, you know, sometimes you have that. I can't think of any examples. Something kind of like "Can't You See Me Knocking," where like the whole second half of that song is basically just like freestyled jamming. I don't know if it was that sort of situation or if that was kind of always the plan, but that felt different to me. That felt unique to me, and that felt like something that I hadn't necessarily heard before or experienced before on the channel. I don't know, maybe that's a weird thing to focus on, and maybe I'm totally wrong, and maybe it was whatever, it's not even a big deal. But to me, I was like, oh, there's a solo, and then there's the vocals, but he's still going, and then it was another solo, because the vocals stopped again, except it was technically the same solo that kept going, and he just kept going. So yeah, I don't know, maybe that's a weird thing to pick up on. And then I was listening to the, I realised about 2 minutes in, I wasn't necessarily listening to the lyrics too closely, which is fine, because I get comments all the time being like, don't worry about the lyrics sometimes, just like, if you want to, like, just go into the music, and that's fine too. But, you know, I don't want to, like, especially in quite a, like, there was quite a lot here. The bridge here, he's talking about, like, let it go, baby, let it, if music got to free your mind, let it go. Maybe that just backs up my point of I was letting it do that. But then I feel like he was talking about, ooh, will you let your soul go, let your mind go, let your heart go, let your soul go. It felt like a lot of time he was talking to, like, a romantic partner, so I don't know if that was kind of one of those, where it was, like, both could go two ways, but then also it kind of felt like he was talking to, like, the listener and being like, hey, let them play their music and kind of let go via their music, I guess, which is a sentiment that I can agree with, I guess, because that's what I was doing as I was listening to it, as I said. And I kind of I realized about 2 minutes in, I was like, oh, I've not been listening to the lyrics at all. Which I guess just says that it was a sound that I was enjoying. Yeah, and I did enjoy. I'm just reading, seeing if there's anything of note in the comments, but it doesn't really look like it. Although, to be fair, this video only has, like, 3,000 views, because I looked for a lyric video rather than, like, something else. But anyway, I enjoyed it. I had a good time. It's as I said, it matches, like, the sunny vibe. I always like when a song kind of comes down a little bit and, like, slows the pace down and brings the tone down a little bit and then comes back up into what it was earlier, which as soon as they kind of brought it down, I was hoping that would be the case, and it was. But either way, I feel like, you know, when you listen to music, you're drawn to whatever you're drawn to, or your natural conclusion is whatever that is, whether right or wrong. Sometimes you listen to music and that changes over time. Maybe if I listen to this song in particular more and more, I'll get more out of, like, what the lyrics were going for or what he was talking about. But in the moment, I was kind of, like, lost in the music itself and the sound of it. And then I guess when he started talking about losing yourself to the music, I was like, okay, that's perfect. I'm just going to keep doing that. I think I'm happy to call it there. But I had a great time with it. It was very enjoyable. So thank you, Jeff, for suggesting that one. It was good. I did enjoy it. And as I said, we've been doing a bit of Led Zeppelin. We're doing a bit of CCR recently, and I've been having a great time with all those. This feels like it's a similar sort of, along a similar track, or a lot of similar sort of vibe, similar sort of energy, even though this is more like, I guess they were kind of more prevalent during the 90s, which is interesting in itself. So I definitely would be interested to hear more of what they've got going on and more of their sound, given that this to me feels like an earlier sound, but it was something they were doing in the 90s. I'd be interested to hear where they took that. But otherwise, I guess we'll leave it there, and I'll call it. All right, because it's really hot and I don't want to sit in front of this window any longer because I feel like I'm melting and it does bad things to my brain. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you all. Thank you for the support. I feel like I do this a lot, but sorry I didn't upload for the entire past week. It's a long story. Don't worry about it. But I appreciate you all. And I'm trying to not do that. Okay. Right. Appreciate you all. I'll see you on the next episode. All right. Later, guys. Bonk.